So I suppose you're wondering why I gathered you all here today.
Yeah.
Sit down. I want us to rob each other's jobs.
So you saying you want us to rob a pizza joint?
Money in the back, bitch.
A movie theater. And a jewelry store.
Up against the wall!
Precisely. In that order, too. Watch me.
Do this. That's fucking dumb.
My name is Trey Dominus Price. I am a senior at Radford University. I am a production technology major with a minor in the cinematic arts. I am the CEO, head honcho, and all around ace boom coon dude of Production 1200. In the movie Student Heist, I played Trey Dominus Price.
My name is Ramsey Cole. I'm working towards a degree in media studies with a concentration in production technology, along with a double minor in cinematic studies and history, and I played one of the lead roles in Student Heist, Ramsey.
My name is Andrew. I'm a student at Radford University, a member of Production 1200, and I was doing sound for Student Heist.
My name is Shaquise Moore. I am the behind-the-scenes videographer and editor for Production 1200, and I'm a student at Radford University.
This project in and of itself was mighty ambitious. Not that I'm saying that we shouldn't have done this project. I'm saying that three plus locations with several props, items, and things that need to be maintained and managed. It's probably a bit big for our purview at this moment.
I always believed until officially was cut that we could finish the project. I fully believed we could do it.
So like there were like scheduling conflicts with actors and recasting, and like eventually some stuff fell through with locations, and it just kind of fell apart at the end.
We are all amateurs at this. We are amateurs. So with that comes a bunch of mistakes.
We thought that we had dates down correctly, and I took off about 10 days from work to do this, and we didn't get as much done as we needed. So after that, I had to go back to work, and those are about like 12-hour days. So I would do 12 hours at work and then have to be alive to go and film afterwards, which was very hard for me to do.
The time that Ramsey had taken off work, we didn't really do anything as far as production.
Sometimes I can be there an hour to 2 hours, even 3 hours after I'm supposed to get off. So that makes it really hard when I have specific times that I need to go and have a shot done, I need to meet up with people to do filming, or even just trying to get into studio time. That does play a very big role on what I do. And that was one of the main things that got in the way of me being able to really participate to my 100% with Student Heist.
Because Ramsey wasn't available that week, because he had a job that was literally killing him, we couldn't shoot it all that week, really. And then at the end of that week, we decided to recast it just to have it be Steven instead of Ramsey. And then we were able to shoot like a pretty good quantity, like frequently, but because we'd wasted that like good week of shooting time, we just weren't able to finish.
I feel like if we had an actual budget or like a bigger budget, we'd have been able to procure actors. So that way we wouldn't have to have worried, you know, so much about using us, you know, as, you know, the crew as actors as well. And we'd have been able to juggle the schedules a lot better.
There are also things about the locations. One of the locations wasn't really working out with us, and then we were out of contact with them for the longest time, which kind of damaged our going back and filming at said location. Another location that we did eventually be able to film at had to drop out at the last second due to a change of management, so we lost that.
Anything that we've ever filmed, like, outside of the college campus or an apartment, like, we were doing for free.
If we had, you know, an actual budget, we could, you know, pay people to keep these locations open for us for however long we needed to film over so many days. You know, we'd be able to have planned that out really efficiently.
If you don't know how to fail, you won't ever learn from your failures. You can just sit back and look at it and say, well, this sucks. Or you can sit back and say, I should have done this, this, and this differently, and I'll be sure to do that differently next time.
So when Student Heist failed, what I got from it is how we could better manage ourselves and our time to do things a little more efficiently or a little more effectively.
I have learned so much from this experience. It's all about balance, and it's all about managing your time.
I guess another big lesson that we learned was, if you think something needs to change early on, it's best to change it early on. As early as you can make something happen, make it happen. Because waiting is only gonna, like, screw you over in the end.
I pursue film because it's hard. It is so hard. It's long hours. Sometimes you fail and there's no, you know, there's nothing to show for it. But on the off chance that you are able to complete a project, even if it's a small experiment, like an effects, like you want to test out an effect, when you show it to people, and when they're there and they're able to see what you worked on, what you've put hours into, and they smile, they laugh, they cry, whatever, that's why I still do it. That is why I still say, hey guys, I have a project, Lux work on this. It's why I am willing to fail 1,000 times just to succeed once. Because the look on the audience faces when you do succeed, when they are entertained, it's a drug.
It's what I decided I was going to do. It is hard, of course, but it's not like rocket science or biology or history or psychology or what have you.
I'm very passionate about, like, very few things, and I'm very bad at focusing at very few things, but when I sit down in front of, like, Premiere and I just have fun editing, I can sit there for hours on end and just have fun with it. Part of that right now is learning how to use cameras and learning how to film stuff and being in focus.
I mean, the reasons why I'm staying with film, even though I just threw out about 5,000 difficulties that make my life 10 times harder, it's really the only thing that I enjoy doing. I don't look at it as work. I don't look at it as something that I have to do. I've never once felt discouraged or non-motivated to go out and be myself and show the full potential of my creativity that I have.